Thank you, Jesus. Tell somebody that my hair will grow again.
My hair will grow.
My hair will grow again.
Say my hair will grow again.
My hair will grow again.
I will make it again.
I will make it again.
I will succeed again.
I will succeed again.
I will climb up again.
I will climb up again.
With a story like the story of Samson. Amen.
Amen.
The story of Samson that he knew he had so much glory. He knew he had so much dream. He knew nobody can beat his record. He knew he was on his path of a path of success. He knew he was a star. He knew he was a bright star that no one could do what put him down. But little did he know that he would fall into the hands of some evil people, called friends. Little did he know that he would be tricked to lose everything that he had. Many people have risen, but they have been brought down by people that surround them. There's an enemy to progress. There's an enemy against your growth. There's an enemy that will come in the name of friends. That will come in the name of sisters. That will come in the name of brethren. That will come in the name of co-workers. But they are not after friendship. But they are after what? What you carry. They are after what you have. They are after the money you have. They are after the shelter that you can give them, the roof that you can provide for them. They are for the advice you can give them. They are for the solution that you have, but they are not for you. And once they have grabbed what they have taken away, what happens? And so, it happened to Samson. He thought he was hanging around a friend. Samson thought he had a good company, but little did he know that he was dining what with the enemy. Little did he know that the person that he called close friend, the person that he called lover, the person that he called my assistant, my accomplice, the one he trusted in, was a knife to his throat. And so what happened to his life? Samson got what? A big disappointment. Why? Because the person he confided in became an enemy. Hallelujah.
Amen.
There are many Delilahs that will come around people of God. There are many Delilahs that hang around children of God. You don't know their real colors. You don't know the purpose for which they are. They are after something important that you have. They are after your time. They are after your destiny. They are after to slow you down to get to your destination. They are after to bring you down to the pits. And then, Samson was disappointed. You know why he was disappointed? To discover that the one that he trusted in was what? Was an enemy. There are people that you trust that will do what? Disappoint you. There are people that you confide in that will do what? Disappoint. They will disappoint you. We know in the Bible there's this story of our brother Joseph, who thought he was hanging around what? His brothers, his brethren. He thought he was dealing with the right people. He grew up with them, but he didn't know. For 19 years, Joseph has grown up with people that he did not understand the fullness of these people. He thought they were for him. He thought that because they could laugh at each other, all of them were what? For him. But it shocked Joseph one day. He could not believe what? His damn eyes. He could not believe that the people in whom he confided in could be the one to do what? To stab him, to drop him in the pit. It tells us the people that will disappoint you sometimes are not far from you. The people that will put you down may not be very distant from you. They may be close persons that the enemy will use to put you in a pit. And then you'll be what? Disappointed in life. You don't discover people till when you have had what? A disappointment from them. You don't know some people till when something happens. And then they do what? They disappoint you. As I'm talking with you, some people might have disappointed you. Some people you least expected to do something, but have done what? Disappointed you. They might have made you sad. They might have made you lose confidence in them. But what did Joseph do? Joseph did not allow that bitterness to do what? To kill him. Joseph did not allow that spirit of disappointment in his brethren to rule him. But he maintained what? A positive what? Attitude in the disappointment, in the discouragement. Hallelujah. You may have fallen. Somebody may have dropped you and you fell down so hard. But your attitude in that disappointment is what matters. Joseph, because of disappointment, did not say, I will be any kind of person. He said, because this person has done me anything, I can just live my life carelessly. Because that's what happened when you have been disappointed several times in life. What do you say? You say, I'm not trying anymore. I'm not advancing anymore. I'm not making movements anymore. I'm not searching about this. You see people who have been disappointed several times. What happened? You can read it from their countenance. You can read it from their way of manner of dressing. You can read it from their speech. You can read it from the smiles on their face. It's like, it is over. I'm done with this. I am not going after this anymore. I am not trying. What is the need? Because I have been disappointed. I have attempted this several times and nothing is working out for me. And they said, it's over. It's over. But Joseph said, it's a lie. I cannot let what happened to me destroy what is ahead of me. I cannot let the attitude rule me in the house of Potiphar. I have to walk and brace myself. I have to brace myself to be the best. Potiphar did not have one servant. Potiphar had many servants. Potiphar was controlling the treasury of the whole of Egypt. He had not many people working for him. Joseph was not the first person. Joseph made other people working in that Potiphar's place. But Joseph said, I cannot be the last in this place. I cannot be the last. I cannot let the bitterness, I cannot let my past, I cannot let what happened to me continue to rule my life. I have to brace myself. I have to show a better side of me in this house. Disappointment comes to kill some people's dreams. But there are some people that say, it's a lie, you can't come, you can't kill my dream. I want to let you know, disappointment will come negatively. The enemy will use it to cast some people down. But the wise people say, no, disappointment is a manner for me to learn something. Disappointment is an eye opener for me. Disappointment is a way to show me what does not work and what can work. Many of the things that you got disappointed in, some of them were a blessing that they happened to you because now you know the truth that you didn't know. If that door didn't shut, you would not have found another door.
And a greater door.
Hallelujah. Amen. If that person did not leave you, you would not have found a better person. If that exam you didn't fail, you would not have learned more and know more than you knew before the first time.
Amen.
When you write exam several times, the last time you know better than the first time you wrote. You can defend more things than the first time. Your interest become deep. When you speak with so much knowledge than you knew the first time. Hallelujah. Amen. So it's how you look at failure. Some people will die because of what? Failure. Some people will commit suicide because they have failure. Some people will drink poison because they have been failed. Or somebody has disappointed them. Somebody has cheated on them. Some of them, they will walk in the train rail to die because what? Of failure. That is a stupid mindset. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Bible says a righteous man will fall seven times and will do what? He will spring back. Because he has a righteous man mentality. That I am born of God, I'm not of this world. The spirit that lives in me cannot be caged. It's the spirit of rising. It's the spirit of resurrection. It's the spirit of power. It's the spirit that lifts its people up. It's the spirit that walks in the air. And so you can never be held bound by the plans of this world. It's the spirit of greatness. The spirit that can make impossible things possible.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. And so, why others will be whining in the house of Potiphar and remember their past, their mistake, or what they got disappointed. But this guy said, it's a lie, I must shine. I must shine, I must rule. I don't care who is leading, but I must take over. I don't care who is walking close to Potiphar, but I will do my best and take over. I will leave my past behind. I will leave my failures behind. I will leave my mistakes behind. And I will press forth to the mark of the higher calling. Disappointment is just telling you that you have some more work to do.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
It's telling you that there's something more, not on the surface, but in the deep for you to tap into. It says the surface is chaff. The surface is earth, but the deeper one is gold. It's precious stone, it's mineral, it's the deep things. Beautiful things are not found on the surface. They are found where? In the deep. Disappointment is telling you that you need to go what? Deeper. There is something deeper. God does not want to give you the ordinary thing. God does not want to give you just the things that don't look beautiful. God wants the thing that have higher value, that have higher worth. And so God wants you to go deeper. God wants you to press deeper. God wants you to keep going. God wants you to keep hitting it hard. Gold can never be found on the surface. Diamond is not on the surface. It's way deep down. The precious minerals that they use to produce chemicals, they are not found on the surface. They are not found on the surface. The cheaper ones are above. Then the real ones that are valuable and precious, they are way deep. That's why they'll have to go dig. They'll have to dig. Many people start digging. And when they get their dog for some time, they do what? They get so what? Tired. They get tired like Lot Lot's wife, because she has worked for long. Are we not arriving? They say no. So she said, okay, I want to do what? Go back. Eh? I want to go back to where I'm coming from. It's better than to go further. And so she did what? She turned back, and what happened to her? Hallelujah. So that's the spirit of this world, the spirit of surface. That's why many people don't succeed, because many people are just average. They like comfort. They like the comfort zone. They like to gather the sand on the surface. They like to gather the small stones on the surface, the small rocks. But there are some people that don't just want ordinary life. They don't just want the sand. They don't just want the rocks. They want pebbles. They want diamonds. They want onyx. They want topics. They want rubies. They want gold. They want diamond. They want the emeralds. They want the precious stone. They want the choicest thing that human eyes have not seen. They want the dazzling things. And they are willing to pay a price for it.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Disappointment did not come to kill you, but to give you the best. Hallelujah. It didn't come to do what? To kill you. If you settle for the little that you had, that's all you would have had. Hallelujah.
Amen.
If somebody has disappointed you, tell the person what? Thank you. It's not over with me. Hallelujah. Say, it's not over with me. Thank you. It's not over with me. Thank you. It cannot be over. It was not over with Joseph. Joseph did not let what happened to him rule over him. And so it will not be over with me. My life cannot end the way you left me. My life cannot end the way you disappointed me. You disappointed me. And so that is where I will end. Amen. I can already open that way that you think.
Yes, Lord. Yes.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
I'm saying it. That there will be disappointment in this world. You know, God has been disappointed with this world before.
Yes.
Even God Himself.
Mm-hmm.
Hallelujah. Amen. Even God Himself sent His servant to go and collect fruits from a vine that He planted. And the servants went. Did they come back? Those people do what? Yes. The Bible says, and God was what? Angry. He was disappointed. Hallelujah. Giving God two, they will disappoint Him. Many people have disappointed God. Maybe some of you have disappointed God.
Mm-hmm.
Have you disappointed God?
Oh, yes.
Have you let Him down?
Oh, yes.
Now or in the past? So even now you've not let God
even
down.
Now.
How many people do you evangelize?
Even now.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
How much time do you give to prayer?
Mm-hmm.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
God has been disappointed. Why did God burn the whole world with water, cover the whole world with water?
Because He was disappointed.
From day one, Adam and Eve, they disappointed
God.
Yes. And the Bible says, God could cry and he repented why He created what?
Man.
Yeah? I mean, it pained God. If God could be disappointed, then I'm telling you, somewhere along your life, something will disappoint you.
Yeah.
A situation will disappoint you. A result you are expecting may not happen. What you may plan to see in your life may not happen. The person you trusted, what you thought would be your pillow on which you lie, will remove the pillow from underneath you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
God disappointed and condemned the world. You know, Jesus got disappointed. The Bible tells us that He went and started calling His disciples. You know, your life starts succeeding. You call Levi. Immediately he left his tax collecting office and followed you. Call Nathaniel. Call all the best. Peter. All, you know, calling His disciples. And they follow Him. Then He went to some. And He said, follow Me. What did they say?
They just got married.
They have excuse.
I just got married.
Job body line. You have to work on that line. You can't leave that line like that. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. And then he called some. Say no, he's waiting for his father to die so that he can inherit his father's property. Another one said, no, I just got married. I can't leave that.
Mm-hmm.
Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. For Jesus. People have disappointed even more. God. But did it stop Jesus to say, oh, those people that I was really hoping, oh, they have just disappointed me. What will I do again? This is my ministry. What will I do again with this my purpose? Then he gets embittered. He gets bitter and said, it's over. What did Jesus do? To him it was like nothing happened.
He continued.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Said continue.
Continue.
If they disappoint you, do what?
Continue.
When life disappoints you, do what?
Continue.
When situations disappoint you, do what?
Continue.
Well, what you plan for did not happen, what do you do?
Continue.
Just continue. Just continue like nothing happened.
Amen.
It will pain you. It will hurt you, but don't let it rule. Your attitude, maintain the right attitude. Maintain the positive attitude. Because you know that you will rise again. You know you will not end in that place.
Amen.
I said a story yesterday that Albert Einstein, you know Einstein that made the
electricity
that made the light. He was trying to discover electricity, and so he did it, the experiment, 40 times. Can you imagine? He did it 30 times, no light. He kept doing it. It was the 40th time that what happened. The light came. How many times?
40.
40th time. That light came. And what happened? Light came after. And they asked him that, look at how many times you did it. You really failed. You failed. How many times? He said, no, he did not fail. He just learned 40 different ways how to make light come. He did not consider any failure like what? A failure was an opportunity for him to do what? To learn something. It is a teaching experience. What happened to you that is not good and bad and nasty and smelly and confusing is a time for you to take your journal and say, this thing happened to me, I'm writing it down. It is not for a reason. There's something I have to learn here and make sure I apply it for my next stage in life.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Many of you don't write things down. Many of you don't have a book that you journal things down. Many of you don't have books that you write your private experiences down or what you are learning, even from little things. And when we continue that attitude, we never go far. Because successful people are people of details. They are people who pen down information and they use it to climb to the next level. Have you asked yourself, why did I fail? What did you learn from this experience? And put it down. I talk about again this Abraham Lincoln that everybody's celebrating. That he sat for the presidency, he ran for the presidency number 13 times before he made it. Somebody has lifted him. Because how many, I know the people would have been, please don't run again. Huh? Eh? They'll say what? They'll say, please, don't do what? Don't run again. It was number what? How many of us could keep doing something and you fail and you say, well, when you fail, what do you do?
You give up. You just you say it was not meant for you.
It wasn't meant for me.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. The spirit of this country is not giving up when they don't have an answer. It's to do what prays. The culture of a black man is to do what? When you try 1, 2, 3. It's for three is too much. No, I'm saying the culture of where we're coming from is what? When that child fails that exam continually, they just remove that child and send to the capital.
Yeah. There's the note from primary school. Say this one, no more school after class 7.
They're hallelujah. When that child fails the exam, what would be the thing? Hot cane. You know? You fail the exam, you know you can't go to the house. You are very uncomfortable, you know you can't. Eh? It's like some of you here failed exam before and you know how you arrived at the house. Did your mother say something? Did your father say something?
My father used to be and did the never should be. Carry and bring to Yami. What do you call it? Yami.
Yami. Yeah.
I will say my father that they say we will not give my result to
By the way, if you lie, it's supposed to be, it will be worse. You don't even have to lie. For my father, you lie.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Because that's our attitude. We have an attitude towards failure. You are walking, you are in front, your mother behind some dirty, some foolish thing.
You now chop my children, you chop my children, carry on my children.
My mother insulted me one day, I removed my coat, I was driving on the floor like a dog.
One day, everybody passed.
I
am happy. I passed. I'm happy. You know, that my dad don't want to report on it. I'm happy. Come here. You think that the person that takes number one have five minutes? You're happy. You won't carry.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Yes, but what is the culture here and the mindset here? If a child fails exam, what do they do?
They encourage.
What do they say? Baby, you can do it. You know you can.
You can do better.
They call you baby. My mother will call you baby. Will your mother call you baby?
The cable is waiting.
They call it black snake.
Cable is waiting. Yeah, hey. In the daytime we use the cable. We play it anyhow. In the night, that thing come down. You cry.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. What do they do? They find a special class, a special teacher to do what? To do what? Make sure to build a path. But our own people, they don't have money to do what? To waste. Eh? No, even Ken don't fix it. If you can't pass in that school, they just take you from that school. and go and send you in a mushroom school,
yeah,
somewhere that is cheaper.
Mm-hmm.
Instead of sending you to a better school that will do what? Help you to build you up, they'll do what? Because our culture does not tell the real world. Praise the Lord. Our culture does not tolerate what?
Correction.
They don't call no failure. They don't like disappointments.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, where we're coming from, they don't like disappointments. If they are disappointed, you will read it on their faces. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Everybody will know. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. Samson got disappointed. Samson was very much disappointed in who? Delilah. In who?
Delilah.
Beautiful wife.
Verse 20. He says, Judges 16, verse 18. Let's read from there. And when Delilah saw that he had told her all what
was in his heart.
Can you imagine who you are telling your secret to? Who you are telling your secret to? She sent and called for the Lord of the Philistines, saying, come upon this once. Me, come very fast. Don't waste time. This is it. For he has shown me all his heart. Then the Lord of the Philistines came up unto her and brought what?
Money.
You always see who?
Money.
They don't do anything for nothing.
The root of all evil, money.
They don't do anything for what?
Money.
Somebody can sell somebody for power. Mm-hmm. People can sell their country for just to get power into it or connection. Hallelujah. Verse 19. And she made him sleep upon her knees.
Hey,
and she, man. Excuse me. Before people disappoint you, they don't tell you that they are going to what?
Disappoint.
Yeah, they make you feel like, oh yeah,
baby.
You're
very comfortable.
Yeah.
You're very comfortable.
You know that it's going to happen. This plan is going to work so bad, so good, so wonderful. Everything looked wonderful. And so the Bible says in verse 19, she made him sleep upon her knees, and she called for a man, and she cursed him to shave off the 7 locks of his hair. And she began to afflict him, and his strength went from what? Start to afflict him, see. And when he realized that, oh, his power is weak, it's just like any one of us. Verse 20, and she said, the Philistines be upon this Samson. And he woke up from his sleep and said, I will go out as at other times and shake myself. Have you ever thought that you are going to make it? Have you ever thought that you've crossed the T, you've dotted the I's? You know, you've put every peg in its square peg in its hole. Have you ever thought that you've left no stone unturned? This time is going to work. Oh my God. Hallelujah. He didn't know that. He says, I will go out as the other times before and shake myself. But let's read that verse. He said that word. The part that follows. He said, I will shake myself. Then what is the purpose? He did not know that the word. Those locks with the Spirit of God on his head. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord.
The Holy Spirit can go up.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
People that say the Holy Spirit does not go up. Verse 21. Many believers are roaming around. Job. No Holy Spirit. Job has done what? Taking the Holy Spirit away. Dollars has done what? You are calling God but no Holy Spirit. Are there times in your life, your spiritual life, you know that you are really down? You know that it's not there, something is missing. So they should not pretend. You can't walk forever and expect the Holy Spirit to be staying there and eating your money. He doesn't want your money. I said again that God will not want anything that is cheap from you. He wants something very expensive. And the most expensive thing that he wants from his word is your life. No, you understand? Yeah. We think it's money. He wants the most expensive, priceless thing. And the thing that he asks is what? Your life. God did not ask for Abraham's house. He asked for his word, his son. God does not ask cheap things. If you are fond of giving God your cheap time, if it's convenient, if you feel free, that's when you do it for God. If you have time, God does not, he doesn't take it, it's worthless to him. It doesn't cost you anything. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. If that day you are not doing anything, that's when you come to church. Praise the Lord. And so the Bible says, verse 21, and the Philistine, you know, he said, and he did not know that the Lord has departed, verse 21, and the Philistine took him and do what? And put out his word and brought him down to what? Gaza, and bound him with fetters of brass. And he did grind in the prison house. He became a slave. He got disappointed by somebody that he trusted. Hallelujah. Verse 20, and in that state, in that state, he was still calculating. He didn't have eyes. He was blind, but he was calculating in his life.
Nice,
that Delilah, you disappointed me, right? But you think it's over with me? Nice. You think I'll just remain in that condition? I will spring back to my feet. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. There are people that are disappointed. I'm telling you like a church. I'm telling you like a preacher. Even though nobody may be here. You know what? I will spring back to my feet.
Amen.
I will bounce back like a ball.
Hallelujah.
I will spring back. I will not let any circumstances keep me confined in its own definition. I will define the future. And I will trash the past and learn lessons from it.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Amen. I will spring like a springboard. That is how you have to say that you will spring back on your feet. You will spring back. He was there in that meal, but his heart was crying. He was there in that meal, grinding in the prison, grinding for the whole nation. But his heart was crying. His heart was saying, I cannot die this way. I cannot die in this condition. I must spring back to my former self. I will spring back better than I've ever been. I will spring back to take my rightful position. To rule again on earth. I can never be covered. I can never be overshadowed. I can never let them define how my end will be. I will determine the end, and I must get back on my feet.
Amen.
Hallelujah. And then verse 22.
Mm-hmm. However, the hair of his hair began to grow again.
Hallelujah. Let me tell you, your disappointment is an opportunity for your hair to grow.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. For you to do what? To spring back. They say, however, they didn't know. They thought they have shaped him for life. They thought they have taken that glory for life.
Glory.
They thought they have destroyed his future permanently. They didn't know that yearnings in his heart, that tears in his eyes, the yearning for God, for a next move, was causing hair to be popping up, hairs to be rising slowly. They didn't see the hair coming, but he knew and felt every inch of hair was bringing power, was bringing strength, was bringing strength, was bringing strength, was bringing strength. Was bringing strength. And then finally, the hair grew back to where it was. Hallelujah. You will grow back.
Amen.
I'm telling you, you will grow.
Amen.
Well, I'm bigger, amen, larger than it. It will grow back.
Amen.
Amen.
If the God that gave him power didn't want to restore the power, it will not grow back. But he did what? He let the hair grow. They thought they got him. So Mami Wata thought it has gotten you. So evil spirit thought it has you. They are deceiving themselves. Let them live in this illusion because you are rising back.
Hallelujah.
They thought they cash you. They thought they have your wealth. They think you will never rise. They laugh and they mock. They don't know the plan of God in your life that gradually He is putting hair strand by strand, level by level, rising level by level, grace by grace, blessing by blessing. He is adding every day, gradually, every day is a day for one level of upliftment.
Amen.
Sorry to that unclean spirit. Sorry to that people that disappointed you. Sorry to them that abandoned you when you needed them the most. Sorry to them who turned their back on you. Sorry to them who thought they would cancel your resource and make you cry. Sorry because you are rising back again. As long as the Lord liveth, as long as He is the master, as long as He has the key of life and death, as long as that and day belongs in His hands, as long as your life is in His hands, you are rising, you are rising, you are growing again, you are popping taller again. Am I prophesying to somebody in the house?
Yes.
I know who is a loser. They feel a sense. I know who are the loser, Delilah. I know who are the loser, those that hated you. I know those who are the losers, those that don't want to see your good. I know those who are the losers, those that thought your life would remain in that condition. I know those who are the losers, those that knew where you came from and they have designed that that is where you will remain. Those that have already pictured your end in their mind, they are the losers.
Amen.
Because God is putting thread by thread.
Amen.
He is putting collagen by collagen.
Amen.
He is putting bone by bone.
Amen.
He is putting marrow by marrow.
Amen.
He is putting leaf by leaf.
Amen.
He is putting feather by feather. He is putting grace by grace. He is putting His spirit in small portions. He keep adding. He keep adding till one day there will be surprise that a small dog has become a lion.
Amen.
That a chicken is picking. That little one is roaring.
Amen.
And then that fateful morning, they woke up. They said, this blind, helpless puppet is here. This puppet that we can kick and throw. But he they call him puppet, but that day was feeling some strange power in him. He was feeling power oozing out from him. He was feeling the anointing all over him. That anointing that you have lost, you will feel it again.
Amen.
You will feel it again.
Amen.
The power that used to come out from you, you will feel it again.
Amen.
That fire that used to burn in your eyes and in your hands, you will feel it again. That healing that used to run through your blood, you will feel it again. Am I speaking to some people in this house? You touch money in the past, you will touch it again.
Hallelujah.
You make dollars in the past, you will do what?
We'll
store your wealth, you will make it again.
Amen.
They stole your car, you will make it again.
Amen.
They took your peace, but you have peace again.
Amen.
They took your faith, but your faith will rise again.
Hallelujah.
They took your destiny, but you will run again in your future. That day, something different. All days are not the same. Some days you feel downcasted. There's some day power rising in you. Some day you get up with song in your heart. Some day you get up so light. Some day you get up to face this world. Some day you get up because heaven has said, this is the day that the Lord has made for you to march into your inheritance, for you to possess your possession. This is the day that I have assigned that that wedding will take place, that marriage will take place. us whole.
Amen.
He got up on the day of strength. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
And when he got up on that day, what did he do? And the Lord of the Philistines gathered themselves together to offer a great sacrifice unto Dagon, their God, and to rejoice, for they said, our God has delivered Samson, our enemy, into our hands. And when the people saw him, they praised their God, for they said, our God, hallelujah.
That means it wasn't really long before God.
Yes, verse 6. Verse 26, let's go. And Samson said unto the lad that led him by the hand, suffer me that I feel the pillar whereupon the house standeth, that I may lean upon them. Verse 27, because he got up that morning. Verse 27, now the house was full of men and women, and all the lords of the Philistines were there. And there were upon the roof 3,000 men and women that beheld Samson and made sport of him, made fun of him. Verse 28, and then Samson called upon the Lord and said, O Lord, remember me, I pray thee, and strengthen me, I pray thee, once this, only once, O God, that I may avenge the Philistine for my eye, two eyes. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Satan will pay.
Amen.
They will pay.
Pay.
Do you want some demon to pay?
Oh, yes.
Do you want an unclean spirit to pay?
Yes.
They will pay for that pain that they cause. They will pay for any mistake they make in this church. They will pay.
Amen.
Say they will pay.
They will pay.
As you are speaking, you are sending fire to
them.
I want to hear fire.
They will pay.
Fire, fire, fire in the sea. Fire, fire, fire in your kingdom. Fire, fire, fire. All those that team against you. All those that stand against you. Come to pay. 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 All those who stood against this church. Come to pay. They're paying. They're paying. They're paying. We command the wrath of God. We command the fire of God. We command judgment. Jehovah God. They will not go without pay. Samson said they will pay for the two eyes. What do they have to pay for in your life? Yes, Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. They paid. They paid. All the hardship you've gone through, you have to pay it. Hallelujah. In the name of Sende Kaya Bata, Rega Bata La Brosa, Holy Ghost, fire, fire, Holy Ghost, your collapse, your matchet, your ammunition, your bombs, your power, destroy them. Da 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 da
pay with interest in the name of Jesus.
The brothers of Joseph, they came and paid. Hallelujah.
Amen.
They did what?
They paid back.
Hallelujah. The last scripture, Genesis 42:6. Hallelujah.
Amen.
It says, verse 6, Genesis 42:6. Are we there?
Yes.
It says, and Joseph was the governor over the land. Say, I must govern.
I must govern.
I must rise and govern.
Rise and govern.
Govern, govern, govern in this earth. I must govern. I must reign. I must take my rightful place. I must sit in my destiny. I must take my position in life. This Bible must become write my own story. It says, and Joseph was the governor in the land, and he it was that sold to all the people the land. And Joseph's brethren came and did what?
Came and bowed down before him.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
They never bowed down before. They'll bow. Hallelujah.
Amen.
They'll come for you for money.
Amen.
They'll come for you for advice.
Amen.
They'll come to wash your clothes.
Amen.
They'll come to wash your car.
Amen.
They'll come to watch you on TV.
Amen.
They'll come to ask you for mercy.
Amen.
They'll come to see you for solution.
Amen.
They'll come to bow for you.
Amen.
They'll come to bow before you.
Amen.
They will come to ask for mercy from you.
Amen.
Amen.
This is me.
Those that disappointed him, that unclean spirit will come and ask for mercy.
Amen.
Because the position that you put them, they will not pay for years to come.
Oh, yes.
The fire that will burn them, they will not pay it. They will ask, will beg like they beg Jesus. They said, don't cast me in the sea, send me to the shrine. Because the position where Jesus tied them, at that time they could not breathe. And they were begging for him to send them to the pit so that they could take air. You will not give them any air. Jesus did not give them any air. What did he do? He sent them into the pit and sent the pit where? Into the water. He punished them. They must be punished.
Amen.
They must be punished. They must pay.
Amen.
They must pay.
Amen.
They must pay.
Amen.
Every disappointment you've gone through,
amen,
they must pay.
Amen.
All those that work against you, they must pay. All those stand in your destiny, they must pay.
Amen.
They must pay.
Amen.
And they came when he was governor and they did what?
Hallelujah.
And he did not bow. You bowed in your disappointments.
Amen.
You bowed in your worry. Your time to lift your head high has come.
Amen.
You bow in your shame. When you are ashamed, you do what? You bow your head. You can't look into people's faces because they know your story. Because they know your shame. Because they know your hardship. They know what you're going through. And you cannot look into them in the eyes because they know your disgrace. But Jehovah God said, he is standing around. Those who are watching you in your shame, that will be the one to bow when you are lifting up your head.
Amen.
This is my word.
Oh, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
I'm lifting my head again.
Amen.
I am lifting my head again.
Yes,
I am rising again.
Amen.
I am taking over again.
Amen.
I am ruling to govern. Let the heavens hear me. Let the earth hear me. You are sent on a mission. Satan cannot stop it. Darkness cannot stop it. Disappointments will not derail you. Your time to raise your head again. Your time, your head to grow again. Say, my head is growing again. My head is growing again. That money is growing again.
Amen.
That church is growing again.
Amen.
The worship is growing again.
Amen.
The music is growing again.
Amen.
Your business again.
Amen.
Your joy again.
Amen.
Your marital life again.
Amen.
A man disappointed you, put him by the side. Because you are rising again to get the best. Not just the stone of the pebbles, but the deep ones, the precious ones, the well-prepared ones for you. Hallelujah. The Lord be with you all. Thank you, Jesus. Listen to me, and I will direct you. Listen. He says, upon Mount Zion shall you possess your possession. Upon the